Hi all, welcome to my channel, welcome to my world, this is the world away. Now I was going to do 4 issues today, but we're actually going to be doing 5 issues of the Hachette Partworks release of build the Spitfire Mk1a. So we're basically going to be doing stages 75, 76, 77, 78 and 79, which encompasses the main frame of the base. Far too big for me to build on this little workstation here, so we're going to be building it on my new workstation that I've got over the other side. For that reason, the light might be a little bit ropey. I think that's a good word. The sound definitely is, because it's using the sound from the phone. I've used phone cameras, but it's got a higher frame rate, so you hopefully won't get that flickering light effect. But without further ado, you ain't going to believe what you're about to see. Let's get cracking. Okay, so we get to check out the new workbench, and as you can see here, this is the magazine, and we've got lots of bits of wood, lots of bits of trim to actually piece all of this together. Now, I understand this is going to be ginormous, so we get these bits in. It's partly the reason why I'm using this whole workbench. We'll see how this actually, how big this actually is. Now, this is stage 75, so let's get cracking. So the first thing we want to do is we want to take these two plastic panels here. Now we've also got a number in the top right. We want to make sure the number is the same on both, and then just quite simply push them together like that. We've got a metal bracket to put between them, which is going to go in there, and we're going to be screwing that down with PWB screws. These are 6mm screws that look like that, and they're black. So I'll get these in. Oh, it's fun using the workbench, I have to say. It's certainly sturdy, but there's no way with the size that I've heard this is going to be that I'm going to be able to do this where I normally make my videos. Now, I haven't actually perfected the lighting over this side, so hopefully you can see everything okay. That's 3. And lastly, number 4. And that's gone perfect there. Now we need the bases here. And it's base number 1 we need first. They do have numbers on them. And this is going to go into the trough that we've got on the plastic bit here. So this is going to go into here. Just like that. Hopefully you can see that. Now we're going to hold that in from the center here with some silver screws. So a screw will go through this side here, through the board that we got in there. Show you on this side now. Then we've got a washer, and then we're finally finishing that off with one of the nuts. Just like that. I'll tighten everything up afterwards. I just want to get these in so you can see how these boards are going to go. The second one, again, with the number here, is going to go underneath this section. So if I put it up this way now and in exactly the same way, that's going to go in like that. Screw through this side, then a nut, then a washer, sorry, and then a nut. There we go. That's those two panels in place. We need to lie that down now. And then in the middle, we've got this other metal bracket here, which is going to be going on this way, like this. So the flat end is at the top there. And once again, this is going to be held in with 2 bolts and screws. So in that side there, let's turn it over. So it's this way around, then a washer, and then a nut. Now I'm going to be doing the tightening of this in post-production. This is just to give you an idea of how this looks. That's one side. Do this other side here. I can see so far, if this is just one stage, how this is actually going to be. Oh my God. Now this isn't going to be staying in my house. I've already promised this to my father, who is ex-military, ex-RAF actually, so he can find a home for it. But there you go, that's all there is to do in stage 75. So stage 76 here, we've got one board this time. So once again, we're going to be fitting the plastic sides together and putting one board in place. We're going to be actually extending on from what we've already done. So it's actually going to be three boards wide. You can see how big this actually is going to be. So bringing up the board that we've done, and we're going to be working on this side here. We've got another plastic side panel, and this is a shorter one that looks like that. We have got two lengths here. Look, we've got a long one and a short one. This time the number is on the bottom. So when we put this on here, it's going to go this way around. And then once again, we've got another metal plate just to put on here, held into place with the black PWB screws again. Once again, it's going to take four of those. And there we go. That's four of those in place. We're going to take the next board, and this time the number here is going to go to this far side over here. So that's going to fit in just like this. I've added a little bit of light here, so hopefully that's made things a little bit lighter. And then just like last time, we're going to put nuts, washers and bolts, screws. I don't know. We've had that argument in the other side here. So there's a washer. There's a nut on that side, and exactly the same on this side here. A screw through that side, then a washer. Now I'm just tightening up everything that I've done so far. And as you can see, that's now three panels in. Once again, we've got a brace, which is going to have the similar way to last time, just in there like that. Which once again, you guessed it, is held in with the screws, washers and nuts. So that's those two sides in. Then we're going to be putting this side edge in now, which is going to go into this side here. So just fit it in, just like that. Looking perfect so far. God, this thing's big. And we've got this corner clamp, which is just going to hold everything together. So it's going to go in like that. Once again, held in with the black PWB screws. And there we go. That's the corner on. So we've got one whole half done. We've got quite a few nuts and bolts left as well. But that's all there is to do in that stage. So, still with me, stage 77, we're going to be doing even more of the stand here and piecing this together, so then we've got the L-shaped panel completed. Now, I think in the last stage, I was meant to put a nut just into the corner here, so I'm going to do that now before I continue. That will then just ensure everything's kept very rigid there. Perfect. So, at the two pieces we've got left now on this pack, we're going to take the longer piece with the four side here, and that's just going to go into this side here to extend out what we've already done. And once again, we've got this plate, which is going to be going in here. It's going to attach to this side with the black PWB screws. And there you go, that's that side in. Once again, dropping a nut down this side and connecting this from the underside. And this is what the underside is looking like at the moment. I'm going to say something to anyone that's been working on this build, has probably said 100 times now. Oh my God, this is big. This is ginormous. Okay, now we've done that, we're going to be adding the next panel in. This time we want the number here to be facing the furthest away in the middle from this section here. So this is going to be going in like this. And once again, we're going to be holding it in with a nut at this side. And there we go. That's that one in. This is ginormous. Now this time we have another metal brace, which is just going to go into here, facing inwards. All of these face inwards here. So that's going to go in like that. Once again, held in with two nuts, washers and screws. Hopefully you can see this on one of the cameras. If you can't, there'll be a lot of cuts in this video. Even the workbench is too small. I'm trying to emphasize how big this actually is. It is ginormous. And then that's that side on. And once again, I will just tighten these up. Lay it down again, because then we're actually going to be putting this side on, the minimum side here, the smaller side. This time the number wants to be in the top right, so this is going to go around this way here. Get this in, just like that. And then once again, we've got a brace to put in here, which is just going to go on like that, held in with the black PWB screws. And then while I've got it up like this, I'll put the last nut in the bottom there and screw that in. God, I'm having a big problem getting the difference between nuts and bolts today as well. And there you go. That is the end of stage 77. Now we've got stage 78, which again, hope you can see this. You're still bearing with me. We've got two panels to put in this side and the leading edges here. So at the end of it, you know what we're going to be doing? We've pretty much got the shape of the whole base there. So to start this one, we're going to take one of the side panels with the number in the top right. We're going to just piece this to the piece next to it here, like this. Once again, we've got the metal brace here, just like last time, which is going to go in here and held in with PWB screws. Now, when you put the plate in, you want to make sure you've got the right plate. You've got a small thin one and a thicker one. It's the thicker one you want. There we go, that's in. And once again, I'm going to put a bolt down here just to hold this piece in and secure that from the other side with a washer and a nut. So it currently looks just like that. We then want to take the panel with this section here down the bottom, and that's just going to go in like that. Once again, held in with a screw over this side here. Hopefully you can see that, and a nut and a washer. Then once we've done that, we're going to be taking these metal brackets, and this one is going to go in just like that there, facing the other ones here. So I've got both of those in. Just going to tighten that up. One and two. God, you really do need a big desk for this, because we're going to be adding the next panel, this time with a number down the bottom. So that's going to go in here just like this. This time with the smaller bracket here. I believe we've just turned the camera around. This time with the smaller bracket here, once again held in with PWB screws. There we go, that panel's in just at the side here. I know it's just off camera, but once again, I'm going to put another nut down here to keep that one in. So that's what it's looking like at the moment. We've got the last panel to put in, so the number is just going to go up the far side here. So that's going to go in like that. And once again, we're going to put this down with the nuts, bolts and screws just into this point right here. So what we're going to do is, I'm just laughing to myself now. We're going to put the other metal panel in here. That's going to secure those two sections. So we're going to attach that down like we've done the last ones. And there we go. That is all there is to do in that stage. Now, because we're building the full base here, there's no way I'm going to leave it at that. So I do have issue 79. So I think we're going to do issue 79 as well. Okay, I might as well leave this the way it is at the moment. This is issue 79. As you can see, lots of little parts in here. But by the end of this, we should have a complete base looking just like that. So the first thing we're going to do is we're actually going to put the last metal plate in. I haven't got a clue if you can see where these are going. It's just going right in here. And this will hold these six wood bases in place. So that's all of those center ones in place, all facing inwards. We're then going to be taking the plate here, which has got the speaker system on. Now that's going to be going, if I can show you this, on this side here. So it's going to go this way around. Slot that in. Like that. And then once again, we've got a quarter brace, which is just going to go in here like this to hold that into place with the black PWB screws. And then while I've got this on the side camera, we're just going to be putting one of the bolts through here to attach it to the corner piece. I've got no idea how the filming of this is going, because I really did not take you all seriously enough in realising how big this thing actually is. Which now means we're going to be putting the last panel in here. It's just going to go into both sides, keeping this in place. There you go. Piecing it together in the centre section here, once again with the PWB screws. So that's that side in, and once again, reinforcing it with the nuts into the sections below. So we're almost there. We've got one more clamp here just to put in the corner over this side. So I'll get that in. And then once again, just put a nut into this side here. So that is the full frame now on. So if I lie this down, see how big this is? It looks just like that. Now the last thing we're going to do is we've got these pads here to put on onto the other side. They're going the other side here, coming through these holes, and then they're going to be attached from this side. Now when you put this in, we're only going to be attaching this with the four lugs that we've got on this side. So it's only four screws we're putting in. So you're just going to be lining it up like that, pretty much like I've done with that one there, turning it over and then putting them in with the PWB screws. I initially thought we're using eight screws because it's eight holes, it's only four. So when that's done, they should just be connected with four holes here. You should have the studs all the way through on the longer holes here, but nothing in them. And then on the other side, it should look just like that, nice and flush to the board. And that is the stand complete, as in the frame and the base. And let me show you actually how big this is. Oh, the light isn't exactly great in here, but it's the only way I can demonstrate how big this actually is. You ready for this? Look, this is absolutely ginormous. Who in their right mind thought this would be a good idea? But there you go. The base is complete. And there you go. I mean, I'm looking at it down here on the under the workbench, because that's where I've stored it for now. And I have to say, I'm glad it's not staying here, because it is too big. It is just far too big. And I can understand a lot of you might want to just get a Spitfire stand and just display it on the shelf, just having the propeller working, but you won't get that gliding feature with the dynamic base. But it is way bigger than I thought it was, so I'm glad that we managed to do it over at the workstation. But anyway, what do you think? Please put in the comments. I can't wait to hear what you have to say about that. If you like this video, please remember to give me a thumbs up, and if you haven't subscribed already, please remember to subscribe. I think we're up to 48 again. 48% of the people who watch my videos aren't subscribed, so please do me a favor, click that subscribe button, and let's see if we can get the channel to 50,000. We're well on our way at the moment. Other than that, take care.